Headed home.
Headed home.
Goodbye, sunshine. Hello, terrible winter.
Sad.
Sad, but it was fun. And on our last night, Hannah reminded me that I still had not gotten any awesome drone shots.
Yeah.
She remembered right before sunset.
Yeah.
So we ran outside and got this.
We're doing something different on our way home. You notice that my mom is not in the car with us.
Oh, we left Liz.
She didn't want to come back to Minnesota. She decided that she was going to live here now forever by herself.
Nope.
Nope. Wow, look at you.
We're staying at Airbnbs on the way home. And we found Airbnbs that are all not being rented in the days prior to our arrival.
Yeah.
So we know that they'll have been empty. For pandemic safe. Nicer than driving 24 hours in a row.
Yes, definitely. And now we can make a little bit more of like a travel vlog.
What is this, a travel vlog?
Yeah.
Haven't had one of them in a while.
I know. We're filming on our GoPro. Hopefully the audio is fine. Cars come loud.
Just make sure you speak very loudly.
I'm gonna have to edit that.
Alright, we drove all day. We're now at our Airbnb in Georgia.
Georgia.
The land of the peach. And we thought it might be nice to give you a little inside access apartment Airbnb.
It's a house.
House tour. Here's where we're staying on night one.
Shout out to all the Airbnb owners that leave a bowl of treats ready for you.
There's nothing more exciting.
Now I'm eating a Twix. Mom.
What?
You have Airbnbs, correct?
Correct.
Do you leave treats or snacks for your guests?
Yes, of course.
What kinds?
Chips and granola bars.
Ooh.
And then there's coffee, there's tea, there's... spices, there's
nice
fixings so that you could do some like first aid cooking, that kind of stuff.
Oh, so yeah, nice. You're a nice host.
Thank you.
We got sushi and Thai food delivery. Yum. Mm.
We love everything about this Airbnb so far. I think the absolute coolest feature is the fake fireplace that they have. Often when you have a fake fireplace, the flame doesn't look very real, but the kind that they got, the flame looks like remarkably lifelike. Like, I thought it was a real fireplace. Here, show them.
we're on the road again, having breakfast in the back of the car.
Big Daddy.
We're here.
This is where we're staying tonight. I got us a room at Big Daddy's Fireworks.
Wait, it's bumpy over your head. Okay. That guy just came out with a mask on.
That's good.
I don't think we'll be going in there, but it's good to know that Big Daddy's is taking precaution, seriously.
Well, guess what we did?
Forgot to vlog.
We had our second night in a lovely little Airbnb. We got dinner from a feed store.
Yeah, it was good. It was like barbecue. The first night we were in Georgia, and then last night we were in Kentucky. And then tonight we will be in, is it Illinois?
Illinois.
Taking us off the road, all right.
Kentucky used to be Hannah's hometown.
Nope. I actually love saying that. I did almost move to Kentucky. I know my dad interviewed for a job here and we went here and stuff.
That wasn't my job.
I honestly don't know. I think it was probably head of security at a university here. I think.
Yeah.
Because then he went and was the head of security at Yale instead. But we did come here and we looked at the neighborhoods. And there was a reason that we picked the other one over this one. I don't know what it was because I was 8, but I almost lived in Kentucky. I wonder if I would have had a horse farm or something.
Your dream came true.
I know.
I wonder if we would have met.
I don't like horses. I don't like that you say that that's my dream come true.
Yeah, but you want a farm.
I want a goat farm. I mean, the horses are fine, but I'm not a horse person. There's people that are really into horses, I'm not one of them. But I would take a horse. If someone was like, do you want a horse? I'd be like, okay.
You would not turn down a horse.
I wouldn't turn it down, but that's not my dream. My dream would be to have a little goat farm.
If you lived in Kentucky, when we met, we would have been a lot closer to each other.
Yeah, that's true.
Just a one day drive.
Yeah. So anyway, as we drove through each town in Kentucky, Shane kept saying that this is my hometown.
Do you remember these people? There's little Bobby that you used to play with.
Oh. Although, you know what? That reminds me of something. This is a good story.
Okay.
Another place that my dad interviewed for a job was...
We're going less than half a mile.
Okay. Was in San Francisco. And...
Wait, your dad what? I was listening.
Another place that my dad interviewed for a job was in San Francisco.
Oh, okay.
And we went there, my parents and I, and, we were checking out, houses and stuff like that, and my dad was interviewing whatever. And while we were there, I remember we ate dinner at this restaurant. We ate outside, it was really nice. And I remember that there was a pear tree at this restaurant. I had never seen I was 8, I was really excited that there were pears growing off this tree. And there was a little boy my age, I was 8, at the table behind me. And I remember his dad tapped me on the shoulder and said that his son would like to ask me a question. And the kid asked me if I wanted to play.
Oh.
So we got up from dinner.
That's weird.
No, it's not.
To
we're
play
8 years old. It was in a patio restaurant. Okay. We were all done. We were just relaxing. There was probably music. It was nice. Or maybe he asked me what my name was. I remember the dad tapping me and saying, my son has a question for you. And he asked me. But we got up. We got up to play, and we went and played under the pear tree. You're gonna die. This story is so sad. Okay, so we were great friends. When you're a kid, you make friends immediately. But we were best friends already. I'm so excited to have this new friend.
You remember his name?
No, I don't. This is the story. And our parents exchanged addresses for us to write each other.
Jeez.
To be pen pals.
This is moving along very fast.
I know.
I'm surprised you're not married to him today.
I know. Oh, I would have been if this didn't happen. So basically they exchanged addresses, and then when we got home, I got a big letter from this kid with a bunch of photos of him doing stuff over the summer. A nice thing, Dean, do you want to be pen pals? There was no return address on it, and my mom lost their address.
Oh no.
So I was never able to write that. Isn't it the worst story you've ever heard?
That's sad.
That, like, haunts me to this day. I was so upset when I was 8 because I was like, he's going to think that I just didn't want to be pen pals.
Yeah.
And I was really, really upset about it.
Did you return address?
Nope, no return address, and my mom couldn't find the napkin she had written their address on. Can you believe that?
Wow.
So upsetting. It still, like, haunts me to this day that this kid put together this whole package.
I wonder.
With a bunch of photos and, like, all this information, and I just never responded.
I wonder how that person thinks about that memory.
Probably that I was mean and didn't want to be a pen pal. So horrible. So, if anyone knows of anyone who has told the story in the opposite direction, let me know.
Wouldn't that be wild?
Yeah.
If the person heard this and was like, oh my god.
I would love that.
Let's find that person.
Let's find them. So if you were my pen pal that I never wrote back to.
Play under a pear tree at a restaurant in San Francisco. With a little girl and Hannah.
Can you believe that? Have I ever told you that before?
I know I've heard that story.
Really?
Yeah.
I thought so. It's like pretty formative. It was like really upsetting to me, so I'm sure I told you already.
Was that before or after you moved to Kentucky? Alright, well, that's all we got for you for today.
Well, for now at least.
Signing off from Kentucky, hometown of Hannah.
Oh my god.
Goodbye.
Bye.